Yo, what's Gucci Nut Coochie? You already know it's your boy Jay, and I am back with another video. And in today's video, I will be showing you guys everything that you guys need to know to become an elite lockdown on NBA 2K22 for both current gen and next gen, man. Before we go ahead and jump into the video, make sure that you guys hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and make sure to turn on post notifications. I upload pretty much two times every week, 2 to 3 times every week, so you guys can be updated on every single time I upload. But the first thing that you guys want to do is you guys want to come down to features. And then you guys want to come down to controller settings. You want to make sure that you see everything that I have here. First things first, you need your shot meter off. Every elite player knows that you need your shot meter off in order to be an elite shooter in NBA 2K22. Not only do you need your shot meter off, but you also need majority of your pro stick orientations to be on absolute. And this is to make sure that you don't do the wrong dribble moves depending on what side of the court you're on. So just make sure that you keep those on absolute. For lock, all my locks, you have to have double team reaction on manual. And your center also needs it on manual too. So if he doesn't have it on, make sure that you tell him to put on double team reaction manual. And this helps with trappers. So if you're holding for a trapper, you can sit there and hold LT and you can hold LB when they pick the ball up and you'll trap them every single time. The last couple of things, you guys need to copy my pro stick defense. My pro stick defense is on absolute. Make sure that you keep this on absolute. So when you put your hand up, you only have to hold right stick up. You don't have to hold it to the left or right. If you play strictly park and stage, turn your Huda guard off. If you play pro-am and rec, for rec you can't change assignment, so I leave it off as well. But if you play pro-am, I would leave it on and tell the guard to switch your assignment to the actual point guard on the other team. So if you play pro-am, leave it on. If you play park, stage, or rec, leave it off, just so you'll be able to not slide on defense. Now for the last thing, guys, you guys need to focus on defensive assist strength. Now what this does is this makes it to where the AI helps you play a little bit of defense. You don't want this too high, but you don't want none at all. You feel me? The default for you guys would be 50, but you need it on at least 30 or 35. Or you can do 25, up to you, but I like having it in the 30 range. So 9 times out of 10, let's say if he does an explosive behind the back and you have it on 0, you're going to completely not bump him once he does that explosive. He's just going to like explosive and you're going to be completely out the play. Or if you have 50, if you overshoot him, you will be completely out the play as well. So you guys will make sure you have it on 30 or 35 or 25, just so the AI helps just a tiny bit. You don't want that much. Now for the last setting that you guys have to worry about is shot feedback. You always want shot feedback on as a locker center, so you know what the contest is and you know whether it's a green or a white or a yellow contest or a red contest, you feel me? So you guys also need to make sure that you have shot meter feedback on. Just so you guys know that I'm not capping, I'll go to my 2K card and you guys can see I have 162 games played, 81.1 3-point percentage, a 95.7 win percent, 81.4 field goal, and you guys see that I have 241 steals in 162 games played. That's pretty much 2 steals a game. I'm not gonna lie to you, this build is souped. So like I said, if you guys need to go see the build that I made, make sure that you guys go to the video, the most recent video that I posted for my perimeter lockdown. As far as our badges go, I'm gonna give you guys 2 sets of badges. One badge loadout is gonna be for PNR, as you guys see now. And the other badge loadout is going to be for ISO. Now, these are both differentiate depending on who you play. Like, if you're playing a good PNR and he nonsense out to, he likes jumping into PNR, he's boxing and goes into ISO. And this is also going to jump from if you're just playing strictly an ISO player that just loves ISO and feels like he can get open only off ISO. Now, the first thing we're going to do is PNR. Now, this finishing is pretty much simple. All we're going to do is just max slithery finisher, max posterizer, and max limitless takeoff. And for your last badge point, you can either put this on bronze Lob City finisher, you can put it on bronze Pro Touch, or you can put it on bronze Unstrippable just in case you play a guard that might come out the corner to try to strip. For your shooting badges, now, like I said, I have 19 shooting badges as you guys see here, but when you guys see my other build, I have 18. I just hit level 39, so I got 1 extra badge point towards my shooting category. So I chose it on shooting, so now I have 19 shooting badges. Before your shooting badges, the main necessity that you guys need is Hall of Fame Snipe. The reason I say this is because not only does this badge give you a boost towards your whites, but it also gives you a boost towards when you're green as well. So you guys want to make sure that you guys have Hall of Fame Sniper on. You need Silver Hot Zone Hunter for your hot zones. You need Bronze Deadeye so you guys will be able to hit contested shots out the corner. Now, here's the thing. If you're a guard that likes to take a lot of shots out the corner and you feel like you might need blinders, you can run blinders either bronze or silver. But I don't run blinders. I run silver catch and shoot. I run bronze limitless spot up for when I come out the corner to shoot. I run bronze stop and pop. And for the rest of my badges, I run silver corner specialist and I run bronze green machine. This is usually what I run when I play lock out the corner. Now for my playmaking badges, you guys see I don't have all my playmaking badges and I haven't maxed out my like pass accuracy or my ball handle to be able to get the rest of my stuff. But when I do max out, I'll just tell you guys what I'll do when I max out. I'll put silver bullet pass on because you will need that. That costs 3 badge points. I'll put silver unpluckable because I will need max unpluckable. Gold quick first step. I might either jump between gold or Hall of Fame glue hands. Depends on the situation, but I might go Hall of Fame glue hands. And then I'll run gold downhill. And for the rest, you guys see I get 5 playmaking badges. I'll probably just put the rest on glue hands. Maybe downhill and then maybe bail out for the rest of them, but that's pretty much what I do for my playmaking. Now like I said guys, if you're playing a person that you know is going to be strictly PNR, or this isn't the 1v1 court where you know it's going to be strictly isolation, this is for your PNR right here. So what I run is silver chase down, I run gold hustler, Hall of Fame menace, Hall of Fame pickpocket, bronze rim protector, I run Hall of Fame clamps, Hall of Fame interceptor. Now don't worry about off-ball pest. You can put it on if you want, but I didn't put off-ball pest on. Bronze rebound chaser, Hall of Fame pick dodger, silver intimidator. Now this is for threes. If you play pro-am or you play rec, you don't need rebound chaser, so you can take that off and you can put that elsewhere. You can put that on ball stripper, you can put that on off-ball pest, you can put it on tireless defender, you can put it anywhere else you want. But me personally, since I don't play that much 5v5 anymore, I'm gonna go rebound chaser. So that way I can help my center get a board off the offensive rebounds. And just in case I switch with them, I can get a defensive board as well. So this is what I would run for PNR. Now guys, in terms of your ISO, if you're playing ISO players that love to sit there and spam dribble moves and do all the extra stuff, just worry about the necessities first. So intimidator, you never know when an ISO player might go into a PNR because he's getting boxed. So you still want some type of pick dodger, but you just don't want it as high because it will be like a waste. So I'd either put it on bronze or silver. In this case, I'll probably go silver. Since you're playing ISO, you'll also want rebound chaser because you'll never know when you'll make him miss in the paint and you can't grab the board or he'll grab his own board. So you want rebound chaser. Ball stripper is a must now because you're playing somebody that's going to be rim running pretty much all the time or shooting a three. So you want ball stripper, either bronze or silver. I'll run a bronze in this case. Hall of Fame clamps, Hall of Fame is interceptor, and then you can either run this, and you can run silver hustler and silver chase down. But I'll run my rim protector a bit higher, so I'll run that as silver, and then I'll probably run hustler on gold. So instead of rim protector on bronze like we had in PNR, I'll run it silver because there's more of a chance he's going to go to the paint. So these are pretty much the badges that I would run for ISO. If I was to change anything else up, I'll probably just make my interceptor probably a bit lower because I know 9 times out of 10 we're not in a PNR anymore. So I'd probably just make my ball stripper a bit higher and move Hall of Fame hustler up a bit. This is pretty much what I'd probably run in terms of ISO players. For the last couple of things that you guys will need, you guys need to make sure that you guys are running extreme clamps, takeover, and you guys need accelerator. These are the most important like takeovers besides probably sharp take. If you was to run sharp take secondary and then the accelerator badge, it would be still be good because you get your takeover faster when you have this takeover method and you have these perks. Alright guys, so you guys already know that I did not have an 80 ball handle on this build yet because I don't have the VC to max it out. So I'm going to tell you guys the best animations that I use from current gen on my 2A slash in place, so you guys will be able to use this animations on this game. So you guys want to make sure you have quick dribble style. You guys get that when you max out. For your signature size up, you want LaMelo Ball, or what you could do is you could put Jimmy Butler on. Either one, but I use LaMelo Ball. Or I would use pro when you guys max out. That's for a 75 ball handle. For your signature combos, I would use Baron Davis. Baron Davis is pretty good. You guys see the little animation you get there. You get speed boost out of it. For your size up escapes, you can use either Trae Young, but you guys see I don't have the ball handle yet. You can use Trae Young. You can use LeBron James if you guys want the AI step back. Or you can use pro. Up to you. Those are the best escapes in the game. For your move and cross, or you can use Scottie Pippen. I think you can get Scottie Pippen. Nah, you can't get Pippen in this. But for your moving crossovers, you guys want to make sure you either have pro, you guys want Steph Curry, or you guys want Giannis. Steph Curry is pretty much the best one in my opinion, or you can use pro. As far as the moving behind the back, you guys want to make sure you either have Kawhi Leonard or you want Damian Lillard, so you can get either the Pro 6 animation from last year, or you can get Pro 3 out of Damian Lillard from last year. Now for the rest of them, you can either put the move and spin, you can put on basic. You want basic so you guys can get the spin back move every single time. For your move and hesitation, you guys want KD. KD is the best hesitation in the game. Not gonna lie to you. Or you can put Scottie Pippen on. Scottie Pippen on is pretty OP. Moving step back, I use Kawhi Leonard because it's pretty good in terms of like just getting a really quick one. Or if you want the 2K17 step back, you guys can put on Kyrie Irving. Now guys, for the fastest jump shot in the game, you guys saw how fast I was shooting the ball. Literally, I was shooting the ball while literally having a defender in my face and it was not contested. And I did not even have blinders on. This is the jump shot that you guys want. You guys want base 3 for the base, you want release 15 for release 1, and you guys want release 26 for release 2. Now, since I'm 6'6", I have a 3-tick jump shot. So what I mean by tick is you guys see that it moves 1, 2, 3. That means that I have a fast jump shot in terms of speed. So I get this shot off really good. If you guys have a 6'5 lock or under, I would suggest either using a 3-tick or a 4-tick. Now 4-tick, I'm not sure how fast that is, but I'm pretty sure it's faster than my current jump shot. And then for your release 15, you guys wanna make sure you have it on 49%. And for release 26, you guys wanna make sure you have that on 51%, which gives you a really good glitchy jump shot. Now guys, as far as my dunks, I already showed you guys my dunks in an earlier video, but I'll go ahead and repeat them. I don't have flashy dunks. Now, some of these like say back scratchers, but this back scratcher isn't really a back scratcher. It's like a really good quick drop in. It doesn't like extend all the way backwards. So I usually run that one specific back scratcher that says quick drop ins. I'll run the regular, all of them for the quick drop ins, double clutches, just a lot of dunks that don't get blocked a lot. That's the main thing you guys want. You do get contact dunks on this build, so make sure you equip your pro contact dunks. For my one footed, I only have quick drop-ins, cradle dunks, pros. I was thinking of using athletic, but I don't know how many like bad dunks they might come in, so I didn't worry about them. You don't get standing dunks on this build. And as far as signature dunks, I said it in the earlier video, Russell Westbrook is the most overpowered dunk package in the game because it has very fast dunks all over the floor. You can do either Russell Westbrook or you can buy James Harden as well. James Harden has some really good glitchy dunk packages as well. So make sure you choose between those two. And for your last couple of dunks, you guys get the alley-oops. You guys want to put on Pro and Elite. And don't worry about the park ones. The park ones are like really excessive. And make sure you guys put on pro contact dunks for your contact alley-oops. But yeah, guys, that's everything that you guys need to know in terms of settings, badges, jump shots, animations, everything that you guys need to be able to become an elite lockdown on NBA 2K22. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. It's been your boy Jay. I love y'all, and I'm out, man. Peace. Say you want me, then you out of love, baby girl, you out of love.